welcome back to another travel video with Sunny, and this time I'm taking you to Portugal, and more specifically the capital, Lisbon. In this video I will show you the things that you have to visit when you are here, so stay tuned for that. Let's just jump right into it and start with where I'm at the moment, and this is Belém. Belém is a beautiful monument that is very important to the Portuguese history. Why is it so important? Well, Belém was the last piece of Portugal the sailors would see before leaving this beautiful country to explore and to fight. The monument is sadly not in the city center, so to get here you need to take the train from the main train station called Casa de Sondra to the train station called Belém. So pretty easy and definitely worth the little trip. Behind me we have Rua Augusta Arch, which is a beautiful building that was built to mark the reconstruction of the earthquake that happened in 1755. It holds so much history, definitely a place you have to see and a great way to start your whole Portugal trip into the city. Welcome to Pink Street. This is a super popular street here in Lisbon. The reason for why this is such a popular street, it's obviously because of the pink floor and the cool bars. History is also very important in Pink Street because this is the place where all the sailors came to get drunk, to gamble, and it used to be the red light district, if you know what that means. So all the bars here are named after super popular ports. You can find Oslo and Liverpool. It keeps coming more and more and more. So definitely a street to experience all the different bars and have the best time. And by the way, this street has been pink since 2013. Portugal is famous for all of their castles, and there's over 150, but we are standing on one of the oldest ones, which is called St. George Castle. And on top of that, it's also located on the highest hill in Lisbon, which means you will get the best view out of the whole city, and it's definitely worth checking out. Next stop is Alfama. This is the oldest part in Lisboa. This part is filled with beautiful paintings on the walls and also beautiful patterns which are inspired by North Africa. But you will definitely see some Morocco vibes going on here. Furthermore, this is also a part of the town which is filled with cool trams going up and down the San Francisco kind of style hills. So they're very steep. You will also see tuk-tuks going up and down the small narrow streets. If you keep walking a little bit more, you will get to a huge flea market with heaps of stands everywhere. So cool. And then there's also churches and there's some castles. A lot of things is going on here. And you will see something beautiful around every corner. A must-see when you are in Alfama is the viewpoints. And this is called Miradouro de San Luis. This gives you a beautiful view over the east side of Portugal, or Lisbon, of course. Welcome to Cascais. It used to be an old fish town, only 40 minutes away from the busy life in Lisbon. But when you get to Cascais, you will be met by a long beach line, and this is probably where most people go to have a swim. Cascais offers also more than that. Beautiful narrow streets filled with heaps of restaurants offering Portuguese food. And the most beautiful and stunning thing about Cascais is definitely the castle. And as you can see here, to one of the castles, you have seriously 20 seconds before the water rushes in and rushes out. So to get here, you need to sneak in, jump from rock to rock, and then you will be met by this beautiful castle. And you'll probably be here alone because not that many people is down here. It's even more beautiful castles along the way, so just stroll by, get the Portuguese vibe in, get your train tickets, get your ass down here, and enjoy Cascais. By the way guys, keep walking until you just see the water and these stones, because then you will catch the best sunset ever, I promise. Next one on the list is only 40 minutes away by train, and it's called Sintra. When you are here, you have to visit Quinta da Regulaira, which is on UNESCO's World Heritage List. It is known for beautiful architecture. Beautiful garden implemented by romantic architecture, and it's definitely just a huge must. But don't stop there, guys, because Sintra also has a beautiful castle called Pena Castle, and it's very famous, and you've probably seen heaps of photos from there. It's located in Sintra as well, so you should definitely go up there. Anyways, Sintra is gonna be a well worth visit. And last thing on my list is Bairro Alto. Bairro Alto is an area which is famous for their nightlife. It's kind of the heart of Lisbon when it comes to partying. So it gets pretty crowded here because everybody wants to visit the cool bars. Although it's known for the nightlife, it's way more than just that. Because Bairro Alto is sort of the center in Lisbon. So you will see street performers, you will see restaurants, you will see cute coffee shops where people would drink their coffee outside and have a good time. If you like shopping, this is definitely where you will go because this place offers heaps of shopping opportunities, and you've seen stores like Zara, H&M, and then more stores that are kind of more special and unique. This is also where you find some of the markets they have, and right now the Christmas market is going on because it's Christmas. You will also stroll by the lift called Santa Justa Lift, which was built way back in time, like in the 1900s, and it connects the streets. So, pretty cool. People take photos there. Don't think you can go to Lisbon without actually just ending up here, even though we want it or not. So, then you know a little bit more for when you end up here. Congratulations, you just made it to the end of my travel video. I hope this gave you a better understanding about how Lisbon works and what to do and what to see when you are here. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up. I guess that's it. I'll see you guys next Sunday as per usual. So, bye for now. Ah! Oh!